Hey guys, good morning. It's the last day of the Overland Bound Off the Grid Rally, and I'm here with Harley to check out. This is kind of a celebrity vehicle. We have a saying. It doesn't matter what you drive, and the proof is right here. This Subaru Forester went all the way to the top of Bald Mountain yesterday, and there are a couple of gatekeepers that put the best four-wheel drives in a challenging situation. The Forester went right up it.
Definitely.
You might have a different perspective of that. From my perspective, it went right up it. But why don't you tell us a little bit about FosRoamer, and then we will do a rig walk around and talk about the Forester.
Yeah, definitely. So FosRoamer, I've had the, this is a 2010 Subaru Forester.
Yep.
I had it for about 4 years. I've always been in the outdoor lifestyle. We're really big into backpacking, hiking, all that stuff. So we were in a vehicle to just kind of get us out there.
Mm-hmm.
And we were super stoked on the Forester. We knew it was really capable. And the whole thing about FosRoamer is it's all about adventure. It's all about like just being in the outdoors,
mm-hmm.
Being able to get out there and not having to worry much. So FosRoamer came from the sense of just me loving the outdoors and wanting to be outside, essentially.
Awesome.
And then from there, we essentially decided to start building it up slowly. So over the past year, I've slowly began to modify the vehicle to make it a little bit more capable. And this one's definitely a unicorn.
Right.
So, yeah.
Right.
So,
Yeah.
It's I wanted something unique that stood out, and you know, the Forester was already capable enough. I had mixed emotions up to go 4Runner route, whatever, but
mm-hmm.
I was like, this thing's capable, I'm gonna work with it. So
let me ask you just in general, is it hard to find the standard custom, or is it hard to find the standard overland parts that we associate with the rigs, like sliders, bumpers, front, rear, suspension, etc. Because typically it's not a rig like a 4Runner that you typically do modify. How has that been in general?
Well, it's been interesting.
Uh-huh.
I've kind of went down the rabbit hole this past year.
Okay.
It's not easy.
Okay.
A lot of these rigs in Australia are highly modded. A lot of manufacturers in Australia make rear and front bumpers for these.
Yep.
These come in turbo diesels. These come in high-low in Australia. So with that said, I did look to Australia a lot for inspiration.
Mm-hmm.
But getting parts from there, as you probably know, shipping is crazy expensive.
Yeah.
So it was cost beneficial for me to reach out to local off-road fabricators.
Mm-hmm.
And luckily I met a good one, Leadfoot Off-Road in Southern California.
Leadfoot Off-Road?
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Yeah, they're in Laverne, California,
mm-hmm.
Southern California. Their bread and butter is off-road Jeeps and pre-runners.
Yep.
They wanted to do a special build. Luckily, they wanted to do on something cool.
Yep.
So, to answer your question, yes, it is a challenge,
mm-hmm.
but as the Subaru community, off-roading Subaru community is growing over the past few years, it's getting easier.
Awesome.
Lifts for these things is really easy. There's a great company, he's a personal sponsor of mine, a good friend, Anderson Design and Fabrication,
mm-hmm.
builds the best lifts for Subarus, hands down.
Cool.
He's actually developing, this is on about a 2.5 inch, 3 inch in the rear lift, spacer lift and spring lift. We're about to put a 4 inch on this. We're hoping to get it done for the event, but he couldn't get it built in time. So
a 4 inch lift on a Subaru Forester.
Yeah. Having to do some some rework on the CV joints and
your
structural
suspension
support.
Geometry at that point is going to change a bit, right?
Yeah.
Right.
But Patrick from Anderson Design, he's got it figured out.
Great.
He's a madman.
Great.
So, but yeah.
All right. Yeah. So, so this then would be, this is a custom bumper.
Definitely custom.
Right. Okay.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about it.
Sure.
Like, what do you use it for? What's it capable of doing?
So what it is it's a steel bumper.
Yeah.
A legit steel off-road bumper. Yep.
That's a heavy point.
These are rated recovery points.
Okay.
So again, the guys who built this build Jeep
mm-hmm.
bumpers all day long.
Mm-hmm.
So, these are mounted to the factory rail bumpers. There's mounting points, but they're reinforced with quarter-inch steel. So a lot of people are asking me, this is a unibody vehicle, just like you know some of the Jeep Cherokees are. How are you structurally supporting it? The way that they designed it is there's quarter-inch steel in there. to create more structural support in there, mm-hmm. and so where it'll actually support these. So if I need to like recover someone or have someone recover me, it's super strong. The winch is sat on a quarter inch steel plate.
Yep.
With a 9,500 pound Smittybilt winch.
Okay.
Synthetic.
9,500 pounds. Do you know how much your rig weighs?
No.
Okay.
I have estimates. I would say fully loaded, it's about 45, 46
okay.
pounds.
Okay.
I still want to pull off the freeway
right.
and see if they'll let me weigh it.
Yep.
But I haven't had the opportunity to do it yet.
Yep. Okay.
I definitely need to find out how much it is fully loaded.
Right. Now, in terms of access to the winch,
yeah,
How do you access the winch?
Yeah, yeah, so open up the hood.
Yep.
This little plastic piece pops
yep.
right off.
Oh, got
full
it.
Access to the winch.
Cool.
So, and that was definitely a design feature.
That's custom too?
No, this they just cut into the factory bumper here.
I mean the removing this easily. Did you have to put special
no.
brackets on
no,
it? No, it just does.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's a little snap on. I can't remember the name of them, but they snap on.
Yep.
Hold that little piece of plastic on. For instance, like yesterday, I had to take it off. Super easy. Mm-hmm. I can pop it open if you'd like to see it.
Maybe, yeah.
Yeah,
that'd be great.
Definitely.
We'll get into the details of it.
Yeah.
Now look, I stepped forward as if I'm going to be able to figure this out.
There you go.
Look. All right. There we go.
Super intuitive. So these little plastic clips here pop
yeah,
out.
Yeah. Okay.
Yep. And
got
then
it.
This little plastic piece just comes off, and the winch sits right underneath.
Yep. I see you got synthetic
yeah.
line there.
You're yep. saving, I can top it off if you'd like.
You're saving some weight.
Definitely. Yeah. Definitely.
Cool.
For all the weight I am carrying, I did have to heavily modify the overall cooling system as far as radiator goes. I put a super beefy transcooler in there.
Yep.
So it was an issue for the past few months with just overall cooling going up mountain passes in the extreme heat.
Mm-hmm.
But we've got it dialed in. So right. have a great mechanic who helps me work with all this stuff. So
fantastic.
He's definitely got me dialed in. So.
Now stepping back and looking at this thing, you definitely know it's got an atypical stance.
Yeah, yeah.
Right?
Definitely.
It shows what it's made for at first glance.
Definitely.
Okay, in terms of your LED lights.
Yeah.
What'd you go with?
So I work with since I'm based out of Southern California, there's a company called GG Lighting.
Mm-hmm.
They make awesome lights.
Yep.
They're local to me, so if I ever have any issues, they have lifetime warranties on all their lights.
Cool.
All GG Lighting. All my aftermarket lighting is GG. So fog lights, pillar lights, my
mm-hmm.
light bar, and then I also have rear LED lights. All GG Lighting.
Cool. Rack.
Rack. Leadfoot Off-Road again.
Leadfoot Off-Road. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. And it's custom?
It is. This is a rack design they build for any vehicle.
Got it.
They made it specifically designed for this vehicle to fit in a certain way. But yeah, these are in production. If you have the same model Forester or something mm-hmm. similar size, you can buy these no problem.
Cool.
Yeah.
High lift jack, that thing is going to definitely get you off the ground.
Definitely.
Where do you hook it up? Where do you link the high lift jack?
So when if it's in the rear, uh-huh. I can just jack off the bumper due
uh-huh.
to the angle.
Uh-huh.
I also have some new products from Jeep's needs that are awesome.
Uh-huh.
And this is a product I actually brought here to have some guys test out. These are
okay.
shackles that
yeah.
attach to the high lift jack.
Yeah.
This attaches to the D-ring, or if you have like sliders or a rounded bumper in the front, you could flip it over and jack up off that side. This model here is called their SAM model. It's a little less beefy, a lot
uh-huh.
more price conscious, and this one will actually jack up on the recovery point of
Got
the bumper.
It. Got it.
Yeah.
Yep.
So cool. Yeah.
All right, let's see.
So the lift, did you want to? So
yeah,
the lift,
tell us a little bit
okay.
about the lift. Yeah.
Yeah. So the lift is, again, Anderson Design and Fabrication. It's got a 2 3/8 spacer lift in the rear.
Mm-hmm.
It's got a 2-inch spacer lift in the front.
Mm-hmm.
Eventually, it's going to be a 4-inch. I'm running King Springs. Not a lot of aftermarket suspension mods for these, unfortunately.
Right.
A lot of guys that run Subarus do more performance. Coilovers are more geared towards that market.
Mm-hmm.
They are starting to make coilovers for off-road use for Subarus.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm running King Springs. It gives it another about a half inch lift. So
cool.
Yeah. And then the Sparco Terra rally wheels, running those super light. I was running Steelys for years.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just trying to get a little more conscious of weight.
Yep.
And so save me about 50 pounds.
Oh, great.
Pulling those off.
Yeah, that's considerable.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Good.
Definitely.
Okay. What about the back of this thing?
Okay, so the back of the thing is kind of where everyone likes to hang out. And we'll get into the guts here in just a minute.
But, okay.
So, again, Leadfoot Off-Road, custom rear bumper. This one is in production.
Okay.
Any of you guys,
wow,
on Forester, mm-hmm, with this model can contact Leadfoot Off-Road, and they have the jig. Takes a few days, boom, bolted on. It's a bolt-on bumper.
Wow.
Again,
that's fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's great.
Reinforced quarter-inch steel, mounts directly onto the vehicle,
mm-hmm,
and good to go. So as far as my rear setup goes, I have a front runner, water jerry with spout, wavy and jerry can for my gas.
The spout on the bottom makes all the difference.
Huge. And the
right, you're just like, here you go, water.
Yeah,
yeah, that's great.
This came with a plastic one, and it was super difficult to turn off and on.
Uh-huh.
And they actually make an aftermarket one, I guess due to everyone kind of complaining of that.
Yep.
And the new brass spout has definitely been a game changer on that one.
Yep.
Yeah, just go up to it, fill it up.
Cool.
Recovery tracks, tread, 1100 series.
Mm-hmm.
This is a custom mount built by Leadfoot Off-Road as well.
Okay.
I did use the tread mounts, mm-hmm, factory mounts, and they built me a custom bar to attach.
Right, okay, I see that, yeah.
Yeah, attached to the spare tire. So there's a pin, pull it off, so when I'm not using it.
Mm-hmm.
I do use this as my daily.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, great.
Yeah.
No, fantastic.
So,
mine's the Overland Bound rig is my daily.
Exactly. Yeah, I have no shame in that. I actually love it.
Yep.
And then, you know, the old tried and true trasher rig.
Mm-hmm.
Full size spare. I'm still running the Sealy back there. Full recovery points on the rear. And running a factory 55 hitch link in the rear as well. Again, I used to have a steel hitch link in there, and they make billet aluminum, super strong stuff,
mm-hmm,
to be able to save some weight.
Yep.
I'm just trying to cut where I can. Rhino-Rack Sunseeker. I believe it's a 2.0 meter model.
Mm-hmm.
I know a lot of guys run ARB awnings. I went with this because it just fit my rig better,
uh-huh,
the Rhino-Rack Sunseeker.
Right.
So went with this. It's great. I have the sidewalls for it as well,
mm-hmm,
so if you're getting sun, you know, from certain angles, you can block that out as well. So, and usually just, I'm running an Oz tent, so don't have a rooftop tent, so Oz tent's awesome.
Yep.
Throw everything up on the roof. A lot of people are like, how in the heck do you fit everything in this vehicle? Because it's so small. But everything fits on the roof that I need it to, and then it's usually just me and my girlfriend,
mm-hmm,
and so we have tons of space in the back.
What I like too is the roof is relatively low.
Yeah.
I mean, on mine, I have.
Exactly.
I'm climbing up. I'm shoving things way up, and then having to put it on. So you have a. If
I
it's a relatively
tire,
yeah, if it's a relatively and, lightweight. You
know, yeah. It's totally
great.
Done.
You're good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've seen you, and you get on. You
know, I have to get. I'm kidding.
Vehicle,
I'm climbing up there.
Yeah, to load stuff.
Right.
So. Definitely.
Yep.
Definitely.
Cool.
That is, I didn't even think of that as a feature, but thanks.
It is. No, it is totally a feature. It's nice, especially as you get older.
Yeah, dude, I'm definitely getting older.
All right, let's look in this inside this thing.
Okay, cool. So, all right. Get open here.
I see you. I just noticed you have your shovel mounted on there as well.
Yeah.
That's great.
Shovel mounted, yeah.
Wow.
Okay.
Holy cow. Okay.
So, this is Scout Equipment's Overland Kitchen product.
Mm-hmm.
These guys are a new player in the market.
Mm-hmm.
They're based in San Luis Obispo. Okay. This was a sponsored build. They're one of my sponsors.
Okay.
the first build was on a 4Runner. This is the second build that they've done. This is the, they're going to have three sizes on this. This is the smallest one that they can make. Any size, mm-hmm, any vehicle smaller than this, they said it's going to be a little difficult.
Right.
So, Overland Kitchen product. I'll show you guys kind of the guts of it. I'll talk about the material first, actually.
Okay.
This is a marine grade material. It's a Starboard XL. It's heat resistant, humidity resistant. It's built to be in the sun all day long in the ocean, you know, taking a beating with all the elements thrown at it. Super durable. The first one they built in like a wood material.
Yeah.
They wanted to do something a little bit different than this. They wanted to see how it held up. So I'm essentially prototyping a new design for them. This is the second one they built. They do have two others out on the market. One of them is actually being featured in the REI flagship store in Seattle.
Wow.
So they actually
have... Good job, guys. Yeah.
Yeah. So, cool. Yeah, they've went from kind of this to they're really taking off.
Great.
So, overall weight is about 150 pounds. Mm-hmm. That doesn't include the ARB fridge.
Right.
So that adds a little bit more weight on there.
And these are 900 pounds here. No, I'm kidding.
Oh, yeah. But it feels
heavy.
Like it.
It feels like it.
When you move around, they're fully loaded. For sure. For sure, it feels like it. So let's get into it.
Yeah.
So this is their Overland kitchen here.
Yep.
So it's all kind of tucked away.
Wow. Oh, that's great.
So you have a 2.5 gallon water jerry can. This is all powered through through my auxiliary battery, which is a National Luna Power Pack. It sits underneath where the spare tire used to reside. So I have a ton of space underneath there. It kind of gets dangerous on how much stuff I can put underneath the car. So I have to be, I usually just throw an air pump under there or something like that. 2.5 gallon jerry, water. This is all powered.
Yep. And then you have a dual battery system in the car.
Yes, do have a dual battery
absolutely.
System. Yeah. Which essentially powers my LED lights here.
Yep.
It powers the sink, it powers my fridge. And it's all running through my National Luna, which is plugged in via an Anderson plug to my Blue Systems.
I'm just noticing the LED lighting.
Yeah.
So for night, these are little little nubs
of
illumination.
They definitely put out a lot of light, and
good.
I believe just our Amazon LED lights.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Scout equipment definitely did a good job in wiring this. So everything back here, they helped me wire and get set up and tuned in. I've had before I had the system, I was just running the ARB fridge and an auxiliary battery.
Yeah.
So I also have, I'll pull out the system a little bit more.
Okay.
So this is the sink, obviously.
But wait, there's more.
This is
so
one burner stove.
Yeah.
Just me and my girlfriend. This is all we need.
Yes.
A little more minimalistic. If we do have friends joining us, we have a two burner stove that we just throw on this table here, pulls down.
Fold
it down.
Okay, cool.
This does the job. No problem, super minimalistic, and I have a propane, 1 gallon propane tank that I carry around with us for that. Also has a cutting board, which is nice.
Yep.
This kind of material, you can thrash it, cut on it.
So it doesn't score too badly if you're chopping.
I mean, you can see a little bit of,
yeah.
We've done some use on it. But,
like other cutting blocks.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
Cool.
Exactly. So, but yeah, it's resistant. It could definitely take some knife cuttings. This pops down. Like this, so you have a little bit deeper sink in there.
Mm-hmm.
This is a game changer for my girlfriend especially, just being able to wash up and we're in the middle of nowhere. This is luxury camping for us here. Power,
exactly.
You know.
Water, warm water.
Yeah, warm water showers, what, electricity? So this has been a game changer for us. Even though it's cold coming out normally, you know, it being able to wash your hands, wash your face, it's huge.
Yep.
And then this is the last part of the Overland kitchen system.
Wow.
Yeah. So
you're not rattling going down the road.
Exactly.
Right.
I've had feedback on here. Why do you have that? It's kind of a waste of space. I had it to where I didn't have the foam insert in, and I just threw a bunch of stuff in there, and I was just losing stuff. I was like, where is this? Where's that?
Mm-hmm.
You know, so Scout actually custom made this for me for this application. This is going to be going in all their systems, this insert. I didn't think I would like it, but it really does help keep things organized, a lot more organized. So, definitely. So that's the entire system here. And then I also have more of a dry storage drawer system here. Keeps like plates, napkins, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, it's a lot of storage.
Yeah, yeah. I have a little bit of storage on the sides as well. Mm-hmm. They kind of designed it like that. Close this. Keep it open. And then a full ARB slide here.
Yeah, that unit supports a lot of weight. How is it anchored to the bottom of the Subaru?
So they use the typical place where you get a tow hitch installed, those points.
Okay.
It's on a plate system, and it's bolted on with heavy duty rated bolts to that system. If you notice, when I pull the system out, I do have holes cut in the plate system that allows me to get inside and store more gear. ARB fridge slide. This thing's awesome. I don't need to go into this one. You guys all know what this is.
Right.
So.
Man, that's compact.
Yeah.
That's a good setup.
One of the things I had to definitely take into consideration, I was running, before I had the kitchen system installed, I was running just stock OEM springs. Mm-hmm. And although they're super amazing springs, definitely had to get something stiffer to support the extra weight, just the bumpers and everything. So it's made a huge difference just having those and being able, you know, to take on all the additional weight. So,
Great. Yeah. All right. Hey, is there anything in terms of the interior, like navigation or anything like that, that you want to, do you run standard maps off my iPhone, or is there anything else that you've done?
Pretty much. I have an aftermarket CarPlay stereo, and then I have a CB unit, which is you know, standard.
Yep.
Trying to think what else here. I don't have to take that down the table.
Right, so you got a table there.
Yeah, table there.
As always, when camping, flat space is hard to come by at a huge premium, right?
Yeah.
So every amount of flat space that you can design in your
system. The good thing is, when I was working with Leadfoot, I was telling them some modifications that I wanted to the bumper, and they're kind of new to the overlanding thing.
Yep.
And I told them I wanted a table. They're like, "You want a table in your rear bumper?"
Right.
You know, they're like, and then they did it. They're like, "Okay, this is cool."
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So
okay, got it.
Yeah. So. Yeah, that was cool. Just the little things here and there definitely make this. Cool. Flat surfaces are huge.
Yep.
Yeah, for sure.
What else should we know about what else should we know about your rig? Anything else?
Its name is Herman.
Herman. Right on.
Yeah, it's a he.
Uh-huh.
What else? It does have a WRX turbo engine in it, a Super Turbo engine. Hasn't been tuned. Let's see what else. Yeah, that's a good question. Put me on the spot.
Well, this thing clearly, right? I mean, it proved itself yesterday. Here's your CB. All right, you got your CB antenna there, I think. You've got your GoPro there as well.
Got my GoPro. Yep. I got the most important modification to this vehicle.
Okay.
Okay, this right here. I have two.
Well, awesome. Hey, we are we're honored to have you as part of the crew, man.
Yeah, both sides.
Yeah, and then Herman... clearly, proved itself yesterday. It's a very capable rig.
Yeah, and I have to admit, man, your spotters made my life easy.
Great.
Seriously.
Yeah.
Super skilled.
They're really, they're
really knowledgeable. Skilled. And they really made the trail a piece of cake.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure it was fun to watch from the outside, but.
In that big photo that we did,
we're
going to have to find Herman.
Yeah, definitely. But I just want to say shout out to anyone who wants to do overlanding. It doesn't matter what vehicle you drive. It does not matter.
Right. That's right.
We had a Kia here.
Yep.
Four-wheel drive. Amazing vehicle. It doesn't matter what you drive. You just got to put a little bit of imagination in it.
Yep. It's got to be safe, right, for what you're asking it to do. That's a requirement.
I don't take this thing rock crawling.
Right, exactly.
I'm not. We essentially use the vehicle to go remote camping. It's really capable on that. So.
Cool.
Yeah, shout out to the off-road Subaru guys, Mountain Rue. Uh-huh. So those guys are doing good things in Southern California. The off-road Subaru movement's getting bigger. So as people find out how capable these vehicles are, I don't have to tell the old school Subaru guys that. They've been doing this
since
the 80s. They used to come dual range in the States and with diesel engines and all that. So I do a lot of gear reviews, trip reports. I'm really bad at trip reports. But I love doing gear reviews, love it.
Cool.
So. Anything I've done modification-wise to my vehicle, you can go on FozRoamer.com, check out. I've got some, hopefully, some useful information for Subaru guys. if not, the cool thing about this demographic is I'm not only appealing to Subaru guys, but I'm trying to appeal to more overlanding community.
Yeah, well, we've got friends. There's SUV touring in Australia, and they have such a wide mix of rigs.
Yeah,
and, you know, so yeah, there's a broad appeal.
That's why I love the Overland Bound thing. It's like, no, absolutely. It really doesn't matter what you drive.
Yeah. So you're Foz Roamer everywhere? Facebook, everywhere. Instagram, webpage, everything?
Yeah.
Man, thank you so much
of
for your
course.
Time.
Thank you for
sharing the awesome Foz Roamer rig. Herbert. Frank. Bob.
Harley. Herman.
Herman. Got it. Herman.